to you all, my dear children. Is my audio clear? Good morning, good morning, good morning all. Thank you, Niranjana Devi. Thank you, Srinija. Okay. So let me share the material for you all right now. Just a second. Right, let me share the screen for you all right now. I hope my screen sharing is visible to you all, dear children. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Clear, sir.
Is the screen sharing visible to you all?
Sir, yes, sir. Clear, sir.
Okay, it's visible. Good. Okay, so in the previous class we have completed with the contraction forms, right? Is there any doubt until that, my dear children? Is there any doubts until that? Until contractions, is there any doubt? I don't think there is. Okay. Okay, the speaking part, we will definitely do it. So you are visiting the primary school where you studied classes 1 to 4. After 6 years, okay, you get a chance to go to your standard 2 classroom and you are permitted to sit in the same place where you used to sit. So based on the questions, we are going to speak. Okay, literally not now. Definitely I'll ask you all to speak, don't worry. So the points which you all have to remember is, you'll have to answer the questions like this. What would you remember? What all the memories you will remember? Describe your feelings at that time. How will you feel at that particular time when you go and sit in the same place exactly in grade 2? Third question is, who do you miss very badly? Your friends or teachers? So that's what you're going to say. And fourth one is, share the thoughts with your class. We are going to share our thoughts with the class. It's an interesting speaking activity, I guess. So definitely we'll have it, my dear children. One day we will do it. We'll be doing it. Okay. The writing part, definitely I'm going to give this as a homework very soon. See ya. Look at the question, page number 34. I hope every one of you are having your books. On seeing these pictures, you would have gone down your memory lane. Write a paragraph in about 50 words describing your favorite sport when you were young. It's not necessary that only this picture, from this picture you're going to take. So you can take these pictures as an example. Whichever favorite sport which you have, see here, riding a tire, playing that gilli, then that windmill, no? So you have that windmill. When you run, that particular thing is going to rotate like a fan. Then using catapult or flying kites or playing tops, which is your favorite sport? You're going to explain it within 50 words. This is not going to be a big problem. So don't worry. So definitely it's very simple to write. You're going to write it only in 50 words. 50 words means it's hardly going to come to 3 to 4 lines. That is what it is going to come. So very soon a Google form will be shared to you. So using the link, you can post it as a photo itself. You'll need not convert it into a PDF at all. Just take a photo of it and just upload it there. Okay. The writing part. I hope you all would have listened to it carefully. Inform it to your friends also. Totally 6 games. You're going to write any one. If at all the game which is not here, the game which you played when you were young is not here, it's okay. You can pick any one game, any game. not only from the six picture, you can take any game and write about it and attach it in a Google form. Usually the homework should reach me only through Google form, not through my mail ID. Is that clear, my dear children? So don't ask me when are you going to give this homework. Whenever you spot this, you complete it and send it to me. Is that clear, my dear children? Any doubts here? Okay. Here we have another letter. The paragraph questions will be shared to you. The letter writing also will be, of course, shared to you. So don't worry about that also. We are going to move on with degrees of comparison. Okay, the grammar part called degrees of comparison. Dear children, when it comes to degrees of comparison, there are certain rules to be memorized. So grammar is filled with rules, my dear children. Unless you understand the rule, definitely you can't take over it. Okay. Now we are going to see what is degrees of comparison. Comparison can be made using three forms of an adjective. So in tenses, the verb plays a very important role. When it comes to degrees of comparison, the adjective plays a very important role. What is an adjective? See here, the tiger is a strong animal. We all know tiger is an animal, but it is qualifying the noun called animal, right? We have used the word called strong. Like that, these adjectives are going to be used in the comparison. Okay, strong is going to be the thing, right? Okay, next one. There are three degrees of comparison, my dear children. What are the three? One is positive degree, another one is comparative degree, and third one is the superlative degree. There are three types of degrees. Fine. So I'm going to give you all the basic grammar rule. I'm going to share it right now. You are going to take your notebook and write those rules along with the examples. Is that clear, my dear children? Let me share it for you all right now. Okay, dear children. Okay. So there are three rules, my dear children. Positive degree, comparative degree, and superlative degree. So first, I'll tell you all how to identify a positive degree. Then the comparative, then the superlative degree. Okay. For the ones who did not wasn't here for the thing, no, right? For the ones who did not listen to this, I will tell. Okay, I will tell the homework at the end of the class once again, so you all may listen to it. So right now, I want you all to listen to what I say. So first, we are about to see what is degrees of comparison, and then I will give you the rules pertaining to that. Okay. Okay, now see, I told you there are three types of degrees which are given in the table. Here, this is the table here. Positive degree, comparative degree, and superlative degree. Is that there are three degrees there. One is positive degree, another one is comparative degree, and the third one is superlative degree. How to identify a sentence is breaking for all my dear children. Is it breaking for everyone? Is my voice clear? Is it audible? Please do post the reply immediately. It's breaking, right? Is it still breaking, my dear children? Yeah, is it clear, right? Ramarish, it is clear. Varuna, it is clear. Shair, it is okay. It's okay right now. Because it's very important, you'll have to listen to the rules, my dear children. Okay, I hope now it is clear, right? Is there any problem with somebody? Breaking again. My goodness. So long I have been sitting down here. Clear. says Raja Rishika. Fine. Okay. So positive degree. How to identify a sentence in positive degree? I'll tell you. Look at the adjectives. Adjectives are given in blue color in the table of column, right? Adjectives are given in the blue color in the table. Yes or no? So look at the adjective tall. Tall is given here in positive. Comparative, it is used as taller. And superlative, it is used as tallest. Yes or no? Tall, taller, tallest is the, my goodness, is it okay right now, ma? Because I have to continue. If you all go on, sometimes it's breaking, sometimes it's not breaking, means it's going to be a real problem. Okay, final call. If is my audio clear, just tell me that alone, because I have to focus on grammar. I can't see your messages. Sometime breaking, sometime not clear, na? It's not good. Clear. Right. Thank you all. Fine. Listen. Listen carefully. So, dear children, adjectives play a very important role here. Tall. In positive, we are going to use only the word tall. In comparative, we are going to use ER. Okay. Taller. We are going to use one ER alone. In superlative, it is going to be EST. So this is how we are going to learn it. Is that clear until this one? Tall, taller, tallest. Short, shorter, shortest. High, higher, highest. So that's how we will use it. Is that clear? Is that clear, my dear children? Okay, that's okay. Okay. I will ask you certain adjectives. I will tell it in positive. You are going to tell it into comparative and superlative. Say, for example, if I tell the word tall, you are going to give me taller, tallest. Like that, I'm going to tell. Okay. Now give me the words in comparative and superlative for the word called short. S-H-O-R-T, short. What are the two other forms in comparative and superlative? Short. Shorter and shortest. Very good. Very good, mom. Very good, mom. Okay. Young. Y-O-U-N-G. Young. Young. I want two, ma. Two things together. Got it? You have to put it in comparative as well as superlative. Younger, youngest. Very good, ma. Younger, youngest. Okay. Smart. S-M-A-R-T. Smart. 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 Smarter, smartest. Very good. Very good, my dear children. Okay, now let me tell another word. Intelligent. 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 Niranjana Devi. Very good, ma. Excellent. So some words you can't use ER and EST, my dear children. We can't say intelligenter, intelligentest. There is no words like that, no? They are known as three syllabic words. Intelligent. There are four syllabic words. So more than two syllables itself, what are we supposed to do is, in comparative, we are going to use more intelligent. Is that clear? Stop typing and listen, ma. More intelligent. When it comes in comparative, we can't use ER, right? Intelligenter can't be used. More intelligent, and in superlative we are going to use most intelligent. Is it clear? Wherever you can't use ER and EST, you are going to use more and most. Is that clear, ma? Are you able to understand? Able to understand? Okay. Now give me the word. Give me the comparative and superlative form for the word called popular. 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 Give me the comparative and superlative form. Popular. Very good, Srinija. Very good, Ram Harish. Very good reasoning. You all have understood it well. Very good, Sakti Sri. Very good, Madhini. Ovia, very good. Aranchana, very good. More popular and most popular, because popular is a three syllabic word. Okay. Destructive, 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 destructive. There are three syllabic words, right? Destructive, destructive. Very good, Srinija. Yes, very good, very good, my dear children. More destructive and most destructive. Okay. Now, are you able to understand where to use ER and EST and where to use more and most? Is that clear, ma? Is that clear where to use ER and EST and more and most? Okay, fine. That is very important, my dear children, during transcription. Okay. Syllables are nothing but splitting a word into its minimal segregation. Say, for example, intelligent means intelligent. If you split it, it is going to come under four syllabic word. Popular, popular, popular. It's a three syllabic word. Honest, honest, two syllabic word. So that is known as syllables. Right? It's very simple. You don't worry about it right now. We will learn it definitely. Okay, any doubts in changing the adjectives? Because adjectives play a very important role. Are you clear with changing it into comparative and superlative? Okay, very good. That's fine. That's fine, my dear children. So this is how you are going to do this. Okay. So this is how we are going to change it. And look here, my dear children, how to identify whether a sentence is in positive or comparative or superlative. There is certain rule how to identify it. Okay. So in a sentence, if you have as or so as given here, see, as. If you have as or so as, that sentence is to be identified as a positive degree. Is that clear, ma? Is that clear? Is it clear? When a sentence has as or so as, it might be as tall as so tall as. It is positive degree. Okay. How to identify a sentence whether it is in comparative degree? In comparative degree, you will have ER plus than. Look here. Than. ER plus than will be there. Some places, as I said, no, the words like popular or intelligent, we have more popular only. ER will not be there. So in front, you will have more here. Okay. In front, you will be having more there. If you have that more, you are about to underline it. Okay. ER plus than or more plus than will be there. If it is there, definitely it is going to be that is going to be a comparative degree. Ask your doubts pertaining to the lesson which is taught, my dear children. Once again, I will not repeat this. Whatever I'm teaching you all, there alone you ask some doubts. Otherwise, the last 5 minutes you can ask. Is that clear? Because when I'm teaching grammar, your observation must be here. There is no point of me teaching to walls, right? Some of you all, many of you all are understanding it well. You all are observing well. But if you are keep on posting questions, this is not fine, my dear children. When I say you can post at that particular time alone, you post. Okay? Is it clear, ma? How to identify a comparative degree? Is it clear? So either you will have ER plus than or more plus than there. How to identify superlative degree? This is also very simple. So EST will be there. The plus EST will be there. If the plus EST is there or one of the plus EST is there, definitely it is superlative degree. Sometimes you might not get EST because for the words like intelligent will be changed into most intelligent when it comes to superlative. So at that particular time alone, you will have the plus most. M-O MOST. Most. Is it clear? This is how you will identify a sentence. Any doubts here, my dear children? Any doubts? Okay. Fine. Y'all are clear, right? Right. So now let's look on to the next image. So there are three rules when it comes to degrees of comparison. There are three rules. Just take a look at it and write it in your classwork. Okay, I repeat, write it in your classwork. Got it? This is rule number one for you. It is going to be there on the screen. You can write it as it is. Put the date, write it as degrees of comparison, and write the rules. Got it? I'm telling once again, put the date, write it as degrees of comparison, and write this rule number one. Quickly. Just write this one. This is the first part of your writing. Don't worry if you all have gone out and joined it. Don't worry. This is the first part which I am asking you all to write. Please do copy it like that itself. If you feel my handwriting is bad, just ask me which one to be told. Write it as I have written it. Within the margin, write it very neatly. Make it fast, but don't take a lot of time in writing this. It's rule number one. There are three rules in total. I can't get your comment, Ashwin. I can't understand your text. I can't understand your comment. I asked you all to just copy whatever is here. Please do that right now. Is the screen sharing visible to all dear children? Is it visible? Is it clear? Okay, please do copy it. When you all have finished it, Srinija says NLS, sir. I'm not sure whether it is clear there. Please do copy it quickly. If you all are done with it, just say yes, sir. Okay, Ram Harish has completed. So only 3 minutes or 4 minutes will be given for copying, ma'am, because we can't take the life of the time because you have to move on. That's very important. Copy it. Very good, Siona and Gayatri. Very good, Yuva Bharati. I want everybody to copy it because rules play a very important role when it comes to degrees of comparison. Copied. Yes, very good. Shall we move on to the explanation, ma'am? Explanation. All right. Because if you are still writing, when I am talking also, it's not going to be that good, right? Anybody still copying alone? Just say, wait, sir. Wait, sir. Anybody still copying? Just say, wait, sir. I will wait for you because I can't be in a hurry also. Finished. Okay. I don't want finished yes and all. Anybody, if anybody is there, if you want me to wait, I will wait. Otherwise, we will go on with the explanation. Okay, I hope every one of you have completed. Let me move on with the explanation. Now, this is rule number one, my dear children. So, rule number one, you will not have superlative degree. Only positive degree and comparative degree will be there. Why? Because when it is in superlative degree, what you are supposed to do is what? You will compare with the whole class. Say, for example, I am saying Raja is the best student in your class. Means what I have to do? Raja is the best among plenty of you. But here in rule number one, we are going to only compare two persons or things. Only two are going to be compared. Is that clear, ma? So there is no superlative degree here. Only positive degree and comparative degree are here. First, you have to understand this one. Is that clear? Are you able to understand? Okay. Look at the example. Look at the example. Is it still breaking? My audio, is it clear right now? Is it breaking, ma? It's breaking, right? Okay. Now, is it clear, ma? It's clear, right? Okay, fine. All right. Okay. Now look at the example, dear children. Let's move on to the example. Iron is as heavy as steel. Okay? Iron is as heavy as steel. Now tell me, in what degree is this sentence? Iron is as heavy as steel. What degree is this sentence? The sentence is in which degree, ma? Which degree? Positive or comparative? There are only two degrees. Positive degree. Okay. Plenty of you say positive. Yadu says it's comparative. I told you all know what is comparative. I showed you a picture, a table, and I told you all how to identify a sentence. And below the sentence, I have given it as positive degree. You can't see that and tell, right? Okay. How did you identify that this sentence is in positive degree? What are the two words which are available there to identify that this is in positive degree? Huh? Yes, very good. Resni says it correctly. As and as is there, right? As. Not is as, Sri Kartika. As. As is there, so it is positive degree. After identifying that, it's not simile. Simile is not, so simile doesn't come here, Yadu. Don't break your head. As and as is there. Very good, Shamir. Okay. Now tell me, what is the adjective which is used here, ma? Adjective. Always adjectives will be in between as in a sentence. Heavy. Very good. Srinija says it heavy. Jocelyn, very good. Heavy is the word which is given there. That is the adjective. Okay. So this is how you will identify a sentence, right? Iron is as heavy as steel. So as is a positive word. Heavy is the adjective which is found there. How to identify rule number one? I'll tell you. There are only two things which are compared here, right? What are the two things which are compared here? What are the two things which are compared here? What are the two things which are compared here? Iron and steel. Yes. Very good, my dear children. And only two things are compared there. You can close your eyes and think it as rule number one. So when it is rule number one, definitely there is not going to be any superlative degree there. Okay. Now, how are we supposed to change it into positive degree? Now, dear children, from positive degree, if you want to change it either into comparative or a superlative degree, the object. Object is the last noun which is available. So steel. What is the last noun here? It is steel. So that steel has to be coming in the front. Okay. That steel has to come in front. It will come here. And this iron will automatically go there. Is that clear, ma? Is that clear? So this is how you will shift places. And we are going to change it into comparative degree. So what are we supposed to change it? Here, steel will come this side. So steel is, we will know now, which is heavier, iron or steel? Iron is heavier, right? So steel is not that heavy. So we are going to change it into comparative degree. So definitely we are not going to use as and as. Got it? So we are going to strike it out. So steel is not. How are we going to use heavy in comparative degree? We are going to change it into heavier, right or no? Yes or no? Heavier. After heavier, we are going to use than. Okay. ER has been used and than is used here. Then iron will come at the last. Okay. Steel is not heavier than iron. So this is how it will come when you change it into comparative degree. See here. After doing everything, you have to check one thing. So in comparative degree, what are all needed? In positive degree, as I said, as is there. In comparative degree, we will have ER plus than. See, ER plus than is there. Two things are compared here. So absolutely, it is rule number one. We have changed it into comparative degree. Is that clear, my dear children? Any doubts here? Any doubts? Okay, we'll stop here. Tomorrow, I'm going to tell you all how to change it into positive degree. And we are going to do certain exercises. And later, we'll move on to the second form. Okay? Thank you very much, my dear children. Have a great day. Thank you all.